Welcome back to the Curiosity Wiki channel, the place where you will find the most interesting curiosities and everything you need to know to have a successful life. Hey, if you're here, don't forget to subscribe to the Curiosity Wiki YouTube channel. Activate the bell to be the first to see the new videos. Going to a cafe or a shop, we usually have an idea of what we're going to buy there, but often we make purchases on an impulse that we can't explain later, even to ourselves. Have you ever been in such a situation? Have you ever spent much more than you planned? If so, watch these clever tricks which advertisers use in the hope of getting all our money at once. The last trick is totally unfair. We think it should be banned forever. So, let's see how the marketing experts trick us. Number 10, they use a comparison. If customers think some goods are too expensive and avoid them, marketers use this trick. They simply place a similar product, with a higher price, next to it on the shelf, so that the original one looks cheaper by comparison. That way, its sales will increase again. To be honest, we always suspected this. Number 9, they use psychological tricks on the menu. Here are 5 restaurant tricks that make you order more. Let's take a look at them all. Using family images. Childhood memories bring back beautiful memories. By ordering grandma's soup, we expect our subconscious to take us back to our childhood. Appetizing descriptions. Appetizing descriptions, such as fresh, hot bread with crispy crust, make us react to food reflexes. How could anyone resist? Location. The top of the menu is where you look first. That's why restaurants put the most delicious and expensive dishes there. Don't get caught up in this marketing. Read the menu to the end. Warm colors. It's amazing how much color has to do with our appetite. It's scientifically proven that warm shades are better appetite stimulants. That's why food advertisers use yellow, red, and orange so often. Price tricks. People have trouble parting with their money, and restaurants know it. That's why they often don't indicate the currency. Number 8, they create a legend. Another nice move is to create a legend that will follow the product. Sometimes they don't even care if it makes sense or not. For example, Milky Way did a TV ad in the early 90s, showing the chocolate bar floating in a glass of milk. Meaningless? Of course it does. However, it has become a distinctive feature for Milky Way bars. Number 7, they take advantage of our laziness. Those of us who work in marketing know that we're often too lazy to open the plastic packaging and take just one bottle. They also know that many people would think it's a good idea to take the whole package to use later. Wouldn't you? Number 6, they know human psychology. Red price tag. We tend to associate a red price tag with a low cost, even though that's not always the case. It's possible that the price remains the same, and the label is just a shiny piece of paper. A big trolley. A huge trolley is a well-known trick to coerce us into buying more stuff than we need. If you don't want to spend a lot of money, opt for a smaller one. Movement from left to right. Many shops are set up so that customers walk counterclockwise. We always turn to the left and most often look at the middle of the right wall, exactly where the expiring or most expensive products are placed. Small plates on the floor. Strollers make a lot more noise on them, and we slow down to avoid them. This makes us spend more time in the store, get a good look at the offers, and probably buy more. Number 5, they sell twice as much. Have you ever wondered why people in chewing gum ads always take 2 pieces at a time? Well, it's a trick to make you think that's the right way to chew it. In the meantime, you'll use twice as many pieces in the same period, and the manufacturers will sell more. The same goes for certain medicines and vitamins. Text on a shampoo bottle, reminding you that you can apply shampoo twice, works as well. Number 4, they add authority. Manufacturers are always trying to make their products look more trustworthy and reliable. For example, they inform you that the shampoo contains exotic flower essence, even if it's in a 1 to 10,000 ratio. They may also ignore the real usefulness of this flower for your hair. Another trick is to say that this shampoo is recommended by every stylist in Paris or Hollywood. Number 3, they increase the price for similar products. It turns out that goods for women cost 7% more than similar products for men, despite the fact that the only difference is their color. Why is this so unfair? This phenomenon has been called the pink tax and is due to the view that women are the best customers. It is mainly shampoos, shaving accessories, and baby products. Number 2, they misrepresent the goods. When writing descriptions for food products, marketers often manipulate terms. For example, the famous Pringles chips are not really potato chips, the actual potato content is only 42%. This also explains their unnaturally perfect shape. The same goes for cheeses, especially those packaged separately in slices. The real cheese content is less than 51%. So producers are forced to write that the product contains cheese. Number 1, they make things serve less time. In 1957, Henkel's produced a batch of potato peelers that were so good, people bought the product once in a lifetime. Sales were poor, of course. Then someone came up with a brilliant idea to paint the handles of the peelers the color of potato skins. People started accidentally throwing away the peelers with the peels on, and sales went up again. Thank you for watching this Curiosity Wiki video. If you like our videos, don't forget to subscribe, like, and share.